Here's the deal. I just want a presidential standard for every citizen in the United States. You want to mail in your ballot to Florida and stay at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue? Great. I'm all for it. Everybody else gets the same thing that the president gets. Either we all in this together, one vote, or we're not. And that, now, I do want to say one thing. While we have focused appropriately post-Wisconsin Supreme Court on the mail-in ballot system, don't lose sight of everything else the Wisconsin Democratic Party did leading up to that. Voter contact, digital contact, door-to-door contact, communication by phone. It is the concierge service that we also want to go with the mail-in ballot. But the voting itself, there has to be integrity. And look, I know that the president, who should not be named, wants to reserve the right for the Russians to have a vote here. I just want to make sure the Americans have a right to have a vote, too. And so he'll take care of Russia, but let's take care of every other American, too.
And, you know, there's this big donor that he has put in, Louis DeJoy, who is named as the next head of the post office. He'll be the first postmaster general in 20 years who didn't rise through the agency's ranks. Now, does this scare you a little bit that this man, who is a huge donor to him, will be in charge of what goes on at the post office?
You know, I used to joke in the White House, besides saying never allow a good crisis to go to waste, you know, even paranoid people have enemies too. And so I do think you should look at what's going on at the post office as a twofer, not a onefer. It's both about Election Day and it's about payback to Jeff Bezos, who owns the Washington Post. So it's not just a one-off, one-trick pony attack. And look, everything China and Russia are trying to do to America is to destroy our confidence in the institutions we have and in our government. And if you look really at a wide lens view of what the man that should not be mentioned is trying to do, is he is undermining, whether it's the post office, whether it's the court system, whether it's the rule of law, whether it's actually how you respond to a pandemic, our public health system, he is undermining all our confidence in our capacity, which is exactly the intentions that the Russians and Chinese are trying to do. That, to me, is what people should really, one of the things that you should wake up to is, when you look at what Trump's doing, it's really not different than what the Chinese and Russians are trying to do in trying to either through cybersecurity attacks or other efforts is undermine American confidence in America. And I think that's the biggest threat we have right now. And Trump seems to be a pawn in their efforts. I never realized
you
could
dictators work in interesting ways.
What's that?
Yeah. We'll be back with more with